Ah, the DEC PDP-8 minicomputer, the quintessential minicomputer. 12 bits, late 60s design, well, maybe mid 60s design. They made bajillions of them. Well, maybe 100,000, I don't know. But very, very common architecture, especially in the early 70s. Everyone loves them. And you're thinking that big gray box is not one of them. Well, you're right. It is not a PDP-8E. What is it? Let's slide it out. It's not going to win any beauty contest. This is a clone. This is a Fabritek MP12. Let's take a look at it. Okay, the box here is a very utilitarian custom-made box for the application, but look what's inside. This is the MP12. Let's just get this thing out of the way. I don't want to see that ugly box. All right, look at that. Switches and lights. Yeah, the MP12 is a clone of the PDP-8 architecture. It's somewhat similar to a PDP-8E. It dates from about the same era, the early 70s, early mid 70s or so, and it is very, very stripped down. This is it. This is the entire thing. Well, other than the power supply, of course. This is it. It's about the size of a legal sheet of paper. It fits into, well, a slot using the sandwich here of a couple of aluminum plates. And you can see inside a few boards. The whole processor, more or less, consists of two large boards and then a core plane in the middle. The core plane's not much, it's only 4K. Now, these particular things, these MP12s, were not made to be general purpose computers. Let's open it up. They were made for embedded use. This one in particular was taken out of service only about 5 years ago or so, and was used to control a machine like many of these MP12s. This particular machine here was controlling a film printer, making movies, essentially. It basically controlled light valves and stuff like that. Take a look inside. This is one of the sandwiches, or one of the boards of the sandwich, I should really say. It's TTL. It's very, very, very much early 70s technology here. Looks like we have some interface. That's probably to the bus. It is kind of a semi-custom bus. It is not the PDP-8E's bus. I don't know what it would take to get a PDP-8E, an omnibus card, to work with this. I don't know. May take prayers and sacrifices. I don't know. It's like, take a look at the other side. Don't have to be too concerned about static. This is a good old TTL. It's not impervious to it, but it's pretty darn tough stuff. Gee, can you tell that I pre-unscrewed some of this, being that there are only two screws on each side? Here's the other side. This is basically the meat of the processor. Bunch of TTL. And you can see they really crunched this design down and optimized it. It's far simpler than the PDP-8E. Well, if you think about it, the PDP-8E was the processor was basically three boards, and then the memory section was three boards. And yeah, we're not counting maybe the front panel or the bus loads card, and we're not going to count any of the peripherals. But this, there are no peripherals really. You kind of had to roll your own. But here we can see the construction, the sandwich, and the way they connected the sandwich together were these gold pins. They actually slide in, and apparently they were a bit of a problem in that they kind of, even though they are gold, they kind of got dirty. Remember, these were in factory settings, so there was a lot of dust and strange things in the air. So I understand this was a point of failure. The switch register, get it in. I guess we'll have to do it like this. Very similar to an 8E. Yeah, there are a few more steps you have to do. There's a run button. Obviously, we know what that does. Halt. Well, that halts it. Reset. Well, that resets it. Kind of self-explanatory. We have the link. We have the ION. This switch here basically determines what you're basically dealing with: the accumulator, the program counter, or the memory data. And you have alter, which is somewhat like the deposit key. And you have a switch register with the individual bits. It's not as streamlined as the 8E's switch register, which kind of helps you along. This one you kind of have to do absolutely everything yourself. There's a lot of toggling in, a lot more than the 8E's, simply because I don't think this auto increments or any sort of stuff like that. It's a little bit of a pain in the neck. But it certainly does the job. One thing I just noticed here was, looks like we have a section for ROMs here. I bet you that is for a rim loader or something like that. Anyway, this is a quick look at something you probably have never seen, because these things are just not common. The DEC machines were never really cloned that much. Data General machines were cloned far more. There were at least a few companies that made a go of Data General clones, but very few DEC clones. This is one of them. Fabritek MP12. Fabritek, of course, of Core Memory Plane, and sure enough, there's Core Memory in there. 4K. Can't do much with it, but hey, if you're only running a machine, that may be all you need. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this quick look at a strange computer. This is not officially part of my collection. I was given a few of these things to sell for a friend. And yes, this one is indeed sold, but it's not out of here yet, because the buyer has not gone through completely with the deal yet. So might have to give him a nudge or something. But I figured, you know what, let's make a video of this strange thing, and hey, let you guys take a look at it. Okay, well, if you like what you see, leave a like, helps me out. Maybe subscribe, maybe even look at some of my past videos. Yeah, there's a few of them out there, and some are okay. Some of them probably will get redone at some point, especially the early ones, but hey, why not? So, yeah. Thanks for watching.